Welcome once again to Malcolm's Anatomy. Today we'll be talking about the anatomical position, or in other words, the supine position. Now, this is actually a fundamental or basic knowledge for anyone who has anything at all to do with the field of anatomy. Now, you might wonder, why is the anatomical position of importance in the field of anatomy? Now, the anatomical position is actually a position of reference for anatomical nomenclature. What that means is, when we describe the location of structures in the body, we use terms such as medial, lateral, anterior, posterior, adduction, abduction, and so on and so forth. Now, without the anatomical position, these terms cannot rightly be applied to the body. So these terms, they are applied to the body only when it is in the anatomical position. So without these anatomical position, we cannot conventionally and effectively describe the locations of structures in the body. Now, if you look at the screen here, you will see a typical example of the human body in the anatomical position. Now, with this, you can see. So we want to briefly describe the various components of the human body that plays a key role in determining whether it's in the anatomical position or not. The basic concept of the anatomical position is that the body is standing erect or upright, as you can see. Now, this shows that the body is not in a bent or in a sitting position. Then secondly, the head and the eyes are directed to the front, so our gaze is fixed forward and the head is straight. So going down to the upper limbs, we can see that they are positioned in a relaxed manner, and down to the side of the body, they are not closely drawn to the sides of the body or away from it. Also, we have the palms. The palms, they are directed anteriorly. Take note, anteriorly, not posteriorly. That is to the front, and they are not rotated or folded. They are not pointed towards the thigh or away from the thigh. Then lastly, we have the feet, which is approximately shoulder width apart, with the toes directed to the front. So with this basic understanding of the anatomical position, that is how the human body is positioned in space, we can be able to describe the various locations or structures and how they interact with one another. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you got some value off the content we shared with you. Please do well to leave your likes and your subscribes, and also your sincere comments. Hopefully, we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.